Hello. So in the last session, we have started with our topic that was design of flexural members in steel, and we all know that it is a design of steel beams. It is divided into basically two parts. The first part that we have seen in the last session was pertaining to design of steel beams, and that were laterally unsupported. Yeah. So today we will be seeing the second part of it, that will be design of steel beams, but it now we'll be seeing the laterally supported sections. The basic difference will be between the equations that we'll be using. In the last session, we used table forms, or you can say we used the equations from the tables, and now we'll be solving it using our other method that we'll be seeing now. So moving on to our question, the question today here is, design a simply supported beam of span 6 meters carrying a working dead load of 15 kilonewton per meter and a live load of 10 kilonewton per meter. This question is same as we have seen in the last session. Just the difference is that the sum is to be solved using a laterally supported section rather than the laterally unsupported, or you can say laterally unrestrained section that we saw in the last session. So use Fe410 grade steel, that means Fi will be taking as 250 megapascal. It is mentioned, assume compression flange of beam is laterally restrained throughout. Clear? That means the beam is said to be laterally supported or laterally restrained. Now, how to solve this sum? So, first of all, the parameters will be the same that we have seen in the last session. The first thing will be to find the factored load regarding the working load that is being given in the question. So, the factored dead load here will be 22.5 and the factored live load here will be 15. So the summation of these two will be giving us a total load, and the total load here will be 37.5. And the next step will always be to find the bending moment and the shear force calculation. So bending moment, as it is a simply supported beam and the load is in the form of UDL, the bending moment will be solved by the equation that is WL square by 8. So solving it, we are getting an answer 168.75 kilonewton into meter. And the maximum shear force will be solved by the equation that is WL by 2, and the answer that we are getting is 122.5 kilonewton. So these are the basic things that we'll be doing. And in the last session, after completion of this step, we used to find a trial section using the assumption that was from the equation of KL by R and H by TW. But now we won't be calculating the term the FCR, which was critical stress. So there is no need to find the equations from the table or to assume the data. Now we'll be finding the value of our ZP. As you can see, for laterally supported sections, we always will be using this equation that is mentioned in your clause number 8.2.1.2, and the equation for it is if MD will be equal to beta B ZP Fy upon gamma M0. In the last session that we discussed, the equation here or the terminology here that we used was FBD, that was our bending stress. And to find the bending stress, we used to calculate the value of FCR, that was critical stress, clear? But now here we will be using the term Fy, that is our yield stress. So there is no need to find the relation between our KL by R and H by TW. That will be done only when the question is been asked for laterally unsupported sections. Here the question is for laterally supported, or you can say laterally restrained. So we'll be using this term. Now, as we can see that beta B is to be taken as 1 because it is mentioned in our IS code. So we'll be substituting this equation and we'll be finding the term that is our ZP. So making ZP as the subject, the answer comes out to be 742.5 centimeter cube. So now we'll be providing a section, or we'll be selecting a trial section based on this ZP, that is plastic modulus or section modulus for plasticity. Yeah. So now we'll be going through our NX page, that is our page number 138, that is NXH, which represents plastic properties of beam. And here, as we discussed in the last session, we will be always opting for I section, that will be either IS HB sections or IS MB sections. We will be not opting other sections rather than this, clear? So as the value of ZP here was 742.5, we will be selecting a value that is greater than 742.5. So selecting value greater than 742.5, the section that we will be opting for is out of these cases. But out of these cases, we always need to do, remember that we will be selecting a section that is in either ISMB or either ISHB. Clear? So here we can say that ISMB 350 is sufficient to be provided. So we'll be selecting the section that is ISMB 350 at 0.524 kilonewton per meter, that is the weight. So these are the properties that we'll be dealing with. Now most of the properties you will be getting directly from this page, that is from our IS code. The rest properties will can be calculated or can be obtained from our steel table. So these properties will be using in the numerical portion. And now the next thing will be the section classification. So for section classification, you need to again move on to page number 18 of your IS code. There from table number 2, we'll be opting for our section classification. As the term FY is given in the question to be 250, the epsilon value will be 1. And now we'll be moving on to our plane section. So for plane section, we'll be dealing with this part, that is rolled section. And for that, we'll be finding the ratio, that is B by TF. So B, that was our BF by 2, that comes out to be 170. And TF will be 14.2 as per our steel table, or you can say IS code. So the value here comes out to be 4.92, which is less than 9.4 epsilon, that is belongs to this category. So this is a plastic section. And now we'll be checking the values for our web section. So for web section, we will be always focusing in beams, this row. So the equation or the ratio that we'll be checking is D by TW. Here the D term will be the depth of web. So the overall depth was 400. There we'll be removing our thickness of flange and root radius from both sides. So we'll be deducting that part. And the answer that comes out is 36.24. So it belongs to this category, that is less than 84 epsilon. So it will be under plastic section. As flange and web both are under plastic section, the section can be classified as a plastic. So now we'll be checking our next parameter, that is the susceptibility. So next will be the check for susceptibility to shear buckling, and that can be obtained from this note, that is note number 3. It says that the ratio D by TW should not exceed 67 epsilon for the shear failure. And as we obtained that the value was 36.24, it is less than 67 epsilon, therefore it is okay. So there will be no susceptible section to our shear buckling. So now we'll be moving ahead and we'll be finding the total load inclusive of our self weight of the section, and that is called a check for adequacy of the section, which includes the self weight. So we'll be finding the value of bending moment and shear force again, but this time we'll be adding the self weight of the I section that we have opted for, that is we'll be adding the self weight of our ISMB 350. And the factor self weight of beam, the beam section that was our ISMB 350 was 0.524. We'll be multiplying by 1.5 to make it factored, and the answer comes out to be 0.786. So the total UDL, the total inclusion of dead load and live load excluding our I section was 37.5. So the factor I section weight is 0.786. So the combination of both, that is the summation, gives us the total final value. So the total UDL is 38.286. So from this value now we will be obtaining the bending moment calculation and the shear force calculation again. So bending moment now final will be 172.28 kilonewton meter, and shear force will be 114.86 kilonewton. And now we'll be finding the section, that is our section that we have provided is correct or not. And for that again we'll be using the same equation. We'll be making ZP as our subject, and we'll be substituting the value of MD that we obtained just now here. So the answer here comes out to be 758 centimeter cube. So to resist this amount of load, we need to provide a section that is greater than 758. But we have provided our ISMB 350, whose our ZP, that is plastic modulus, is 889.57. So it is sufficient and it won't fail. So this check is completed. And now we'll be moving to our next part, that is check for design strength of section. That is, we'll be checking the shear strength of the section, whether the section or whether the ISMB 350 that we have provided will be able to carry the shear force or not. And for that, we'll be moving on to page number 59 of your IS code. There you can see from the clause 8.4, we will be finding the value of VD, and the equation for VD here will be Vn upon gamma m0. Gamma m0 is 1.1. So Vn can be obtained from this equation, that is Vn equal to Vp. So we'll be substituting this term in the main equation, and the answer that comes out is Vd equal to Fy by root 3 into gamma m0. And as Av is our shear area can always be obtained from this clause, that is 8.4.1.1. For hot roll sections, the shear area will be H into TW. H, that is our overall height, or you can say depth, and TW, that is our thickness of web. So here the edge portion is 350 and thickness of web is 8.1. So solving it, we are getting a VD to be 372 kilonewton. But now after finding the value of VD, you always need to remember that we always take 60% of this case. That is, you can see here, when the factor design force does not exceed 0.6 VD, that means the VD that we have calculated, we always need to multiply it by 0.6, and that will be our final value of our shear strength. So here, multiplying it by 0.6, the value that we are getting is 223.2, and the shear force that was to be resisted was 114.86, and our section that we have provided resist a shear force of 223.23. So the load that is to be resisted can be safely induced upon, and therefore the section is valid. So our section is okay under a shear capacity or a shear failure. And now we'll be checking the failure regarding our moment. So the next step will be calculation of moment. Again, we'll be using the same equation, but now we'll be finding the value of MD. So the MD value here comes out to be 202.17. We'll be taking the beta B value to be 1 as mentioned here. Okay? So the value here comes out to be 202.17, but for laterally supported sections, you always need to check this paragraph. It says that to avoid irreversible deformation under serviceability loads, MD shall be less than 1.2 ZEFY upon gamma m0 in the case of simply supported, and 1.5 ZEFY upon gamma m0 in the case of cantilever. So as the beam in our case is simply supported, we need to check that this value that we have obtained just now is less than 1.2 ZEFY upon gamma m0. ZE, that is our elastic modulus that we obtained from our page number 138. So solving it, we are getting an answer 212.45. So this value is less than the MD or the maximum value that it can sustain. So our answer is valid, clear? And now we'll be finalizing our checks. These checks are to be done only when laterally supported sections are being asked. And there are total three checks that we'll be looking upon. The first check for it is shear lag, that is check for shear lag. And this can be obtained from page number 53, clause number 8.2.1.5. So moving on to the clause, here it says that the shear lag effects in flanges may be disregarded, provided, that means shear lag is not to be induced or it not to be calculated under these conditions for outstand element and for internal element. For this semester, we'll be always focusing on this point, that is for outstand element. And it says that for outstand elements, BO should be less than or equal to LO upon 20. Yeah? So this should be sufficient, or this condition should be proven. If this condition fails, then we need to design for shear lag. But in this semester, in each and every question of yours, you will be always satisfying this criteria, so shear lag is not to be designed upon. Here the term BO is the width of our flange, and LO is the length between the points of zero moment sections, that means the length of beam. So here you can say that is our BO, or you can say BS is 140, that is our width of flange, and L0 will be 6000 because it is going to equation to be 6 meters. So you can say that the RHS value comes out to be 300 and LHS is 140. So as LHS is less than RHS, there is no shear lag effect to be considered. So this was a check pertaining to shear lag. Now we'll be focusing on second part, that is check for deflection. And for that, we'll be moving on to table number 6, page number 31. But again, you always need to remember while checking for steel design, that is steel beams, that the deflection must be checked only for working live loads. You don't need to find the deflection for the overall loads. Clear? So in the question, if it is asked or if it is given as overall load, there is no bifurcation given. That means the dead load is not being separated and the live load is not being separated. Then you must skip this step. This step is not to be done. This step will only be applicable if dead load and live load are given separately in your question. Clear? Because we will be checking the answer only for live load. So if the live load is mentioned in the question, then only will be pertaining to this step. So now we'll be moving on to this table, that is table number 6, which gives us the deflection limit. So it is basically divided into two parts. The first part is for industrial buildings and the second part is for other buildings. As it is not mentioned in the question that it is an industrial building, we'll be taking this part, that is other buildings. Now again, it is bifurcated into two parts. The first part is for vertical deflection and the second is for lateral deflection. So lateral deflection will be pertaining to either frames or columns. But now as we are dealing with our beam section, we will be focusing on this vertical deflection. And again, vertical deflection is divided into two parts, but for both the cases, we will be considering the live load here. So we will be always opting for live load equations in this case, and that too working live loads. That means if it is given in the equation to be factored, then you need to divide by 1.5 to obtain the value of working live loads. And it is again divided into two parts. The first is floor and roof, and the second is cantilever. So as the question here is for simply supported beams, we will be opting for floor and roof. And we will be always checking this portion, that is element not susceptible to cracking. So our final check will be that the maximum deflection can be included in the section is span upon 300. So the actual deflection of our case should be less than span upon 300 to verify this equation. So first of all, we will be finding the value of actual deflection. As we have studied in the structural analysis portion, for a simply supported section under the UDL action, the actual deflection will always be 5 by 384 W raised to 4 by EI. W will be our working live load, that is given in the question to be 10 kN per meter, so we will be substituting 10 here. And E will be 2 into 10 raised to 5. I will be our moment of inertia that we obtained from our steel table. So the actual deflection here comes out to be 6.20 mm. So now we need to prove that this value is less than our case, that is span by 300. So now we'll be finding the maximum deflection. So the allowable maximum deflection will be L by 300, as the length is given in the question to be 6000. So the answer comes out to be 20. So the maximum deflection that it can carry is 20 mm, and the deflection that is occurring in our section is 6.20. So our check is valid and it won't fail under deflection. So this was our second check, and now we'll be moving on to our third and final check, that is check for web crippling. Now first of all, what do you mean by web crippling? So as you can see in the figure itself, web crippling means the crippling of web. So basically two types of failure occur in web. As this figure shows the buckling, that means the whole section or the whole web is being buckled. But out of the whole section of web, only if a certain portion is getting buckled, then it is called crippling. So as you can see in the left hand side figure, this figure is for crippling. So we'll be checking the answer for the crippling value. Keep in mind that for web crippling checks, the answers or the equations are not mentioned in the IS code. So you need to remember this step thoroughly if it is asked the equation that check for web crippling. So now we'll be moving further and we'll be finding these two cases, that is dispersion length will be equal to B1 plus N2. And assuming stiffness portion of web, that is B1 equal to 75 mm. Now what is this B1 and what is this N2? And for that, we'll be referring this figure. Suppose this is the ISMB section 350 that we have considered. So this length in the horizontal axis, that is a longitudinal axis, this will be the length B1 and this will be the length N2 up to which the crippling load can be sustained. And this depth, that is R plus TF, will be our D1 that we'll be dealing with, clear? So now the equations you need to remember is N2 will be always equal to 2.5 D1. These equations are not mentioned in our IS course, so you need to remember every equation for this. So as N2 equal to 2.D1, the first step will be to calculate the value of D1. And as you can see in the figure itself, that D1 is the summation of root radius plus thickness of flange. So TF plus root radius gives the D1 value, that comes out to be 28.2. And now we'll be substituting the value of D1 in the equation for N2, and we are getting N2 to be 70.5. Now as we have always assuming the value of B1 to be 75, in every case we will be assuming the B1 value to be 75 mm. So here the value B1 plus N2 comes out to be 145.5 mm. So now we'll be finding the value, that is crippling load, that it can occur. So the crippling strength of web, this again is not given in your IS code, will be B1 plus N2 into TW into Fi by gamma M0. This equation you need to remember it. So solving it, we are getting an answer to 67.85 kN. That means it will sustain a load up to 267.85 kN, and it will cripple under this. It will be starting to get crippled only if this load gets exceeded. And as the shear force value in our case was 114.86, so the maximum load that it can resist is 114.86. so the web will be not crippling in our case. So this was our check for crippling, and this was our sum pertaining to laterally supported beam, or you can say laterally supported sections. And this will be our today's exercise problem. Solve it, and in the next session we'll be seeing a furthermore sum. Thank you.